Gojira, 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 Tesla, Gojira, 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 Tesla, Gojira.
Hello everybody, Tesla Gojira here, and today I'm playing Avorion. At least I think that's how you pronounce it. It's published and developed by Boxelware. Avorion is currently in early access, but it looks like it's got enough, enough stuff in it to be a fully enjoyable game. But anyway, I'll read the description here. Several hundred years ago, a cataclysmic catastrophe nearly ripped your galaxy apart. An insurmountable ring of torn hyperspace fabric appeared in the center of the galaxy, which normal hyperspace engines can't overcome. Since this event, nobody has managed to get near the central regions of the galaxy. All you know is that this event also spawned multiple insurmountable hyperspace rifts throughout the entire galaxy, and that a strange race of aliens, the Xsotan, I'm gonna say, it's just X-S-O-T-A-N, so Xsotan, I don't know, has appeared in the center. It looks like these aliens have found a way to surpass the torn hyperspace fabric, but so far nobody has managed to establish contact with them. The description goes on for quite a while, but you get the idea. So I'm gonna get right into playing this here. Single player, create a new galaxy. Default name will be First Impression. Seed, random, difficulty. Let's just go normal. Full corrosion. All right, play. Press spacebar to continue. Oh god, what just happened? Yes, I want the tutorial. Use the mouse to look around the sector. Alright, so that's my little ship thing. Use the mouse wheel to zoom. Okay. Notice the ship turning around. Your ship will automatically steer in the direction you are looking at. If you don't want it to turn, hold control. Got it. You'll have to use your mouse to use the user interface or select things. Hold left shift to release your mouse pointer and click away this message. Okay, you can always end or restart the tutorial button. Okay, WS to move forward and backward. Okay, your thrusters automatically break when you stop pressing S. Pressing backwards won't make your ship break harder. Good to know. For a hardcore break, you have to turn your ship around and accelerate or even boost in the opposite direction. This is especially important for larger ships with high mass. This is your velocity display. Blah, 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 blah. Blue means you're firing or moving in that direction. Orange means you're moving in the opposite direction. So if I'm going this way and then I just swoosh around. So, okay. Use A and D to strafe left and right. An asteroid has been highlighted. Use the middle mouse to select this asteroid by clicking on it. What? Oh, there we go. Pro tip. Fly to your selected asteroid. Hold space to boost. Use your mining lasers to mine the asteroid. Aim with the mouse and use left button to fire. Your targeting circles turn green. Blah, 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 blah. Okay, so it just gets, like, absorbed. Nice. Resources are collected by automatically flying near them. Your collected resources play on the top left of the screen, so I just got a boatload of iron. All players start out with mining drones so they can gather resources. Even in the unfortunate event of your complete and total annihilation, you will always have the drone to start over. Okay. Mine more asteroids until you have 1,000 iron. Asteroids that are rich of resources have bright spots. Look for those. Like that one. Asteroid. Iron. Says it's got 2,039 iron in this baby. Fire, 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 fire! Well, so far, if you want to get my really early first impressions, I love this game. It's simple. I mean, the graphics aren't amazing, but I've always strongly believed that graphics don't make a game. You could have amazing graphics and it'd be a terrible game, or you could have, like, these graphics and be an amazing game. I mean, I'm not trying to bash on these graphics too much. They're plenty good for what I'm doing here, but, yeah. You know what I'm trying to say, I'm sure. Okay. There's another one. Oh, I keep hitting the wrong button. I keep hitting the run button that I normally use on games instead of... not shift, but space. Let's see here. Boom! So I'm not sure why my dude's just like tapping, but he is. And I'm just holding the mouse down. I think it's because he's gotta wait till he turns. Yeah, that looks like that's the problem. Okay, I know there's more around here somewhere. Here's one. I'm at 582. Only need like one more, I think. That ought to do it. Okay. I have all the iron I need. I'll just finish up mining this baby first. Pew, 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 pew. Okay. Click this button to found a new ship. Enter the name of your new ship. Tesla! Hail. Click this button to enter building mode. Oh, nice. You can modify and arm your ships. Okay, this is so cool. So you make it from scratch. Uh-oh. Oops. How do I undo? Oh, okay. Iron engine. Increases immune to electricity weapons, iron cargo bay, iron crew quarters. Your ship has no crew. Okay. Let's go with iron crew quarters on the bottom. Well, how do I get... Hold right mouse to move around and look around. This is the overview. Blah, 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 blah. So, yellow stats may cause inconvenience. Red stats are bad and may cause problems. Okay, these are the tools for your ship building. Mirroring, coloring, snapping blocks to grid, merging and deleting box. This button, you can open the entire build inventory. Okay. This is the engine block. Engines give your ship better acceleration and max velocity. When placing engine, turn your camera to see where it is facing. Your ship needs a crew, and your crew needs living space. The more crew quarters you have, the more crewmen you can work on your ship. This is the thruster block. Thrusters increase rotational speed depending on their position. They also brake your ship and reduce drifting. You can change the size of your current block. Hold A SD or W, move the mouse to scale it in different directions. Okay. So... oh my. Hehehe. Oops. Boom! How's that for an engine? You can delete blocks and turrets by selecting them with the middle mouse and then pressing delete. Use engine thruster and hull blocks to extend your ship. Build thrusters to make sure it can brake and turn in each direction. Okay. Thrusters. Well, I can't see because of the instructions. Iron thruster. Okay. Well, I don't want it to be that big. So... how do I go back to just square? Oh, there we go. That's too big. Predefined shapes. Small square. There we go. Nope. One more bigger than that. This one? Nope. Also not what I wanted. There we go. Okay. I'll put thrusters there. Those weren't thrusters, were they? Brake thrust. Iron cargo bay. I have no idea what I'm doing here. Why the hell is it so damn bright? Engine. Okay. Press B. Change back to your drone in time. Okay. Let's see if I put additional thrusters on this bad boy. the hell was that? Okay. Alright, so I got a basic ship down that can move. So now I need to put a crew in this bad boy. So my ship still has no crew. Good to know. Very weak. Arm it better, edge shields. Okay. So you can delete that thruster. Delete that thruster. Delete. Yeah. Delete that thruster. And delete that thruster. Okay. Iron armor. This is not a pretty ship. She may be ugly, but she's mine. Alright. And then I need to put weapons on her. Chain gun turret. I'll put one there. Oh, I see how it works. Okay. Oh yeah, it probably would help if I put some form of steering on this thing, wouldn't it? As well as a more centrally located one of these doodads. But it doesn't look like centrally located is going to be possible. Thrusters. Put all the thrusters. They did not clarify how to put a crew on here. Idea what I'm doing here. To switch back to your drone, press T while no target is selected. or simply press the drone button on the top right of the screen. Okay. Can I evaporate my own ship? Oh, sweet, I can. Ah! I gotta return to my ship, press T or F to enter it, I need to grab more iron. Jesus, am I not doing anything here? Or is this just a really hefty plant? Or rock, I mean. Looks like this one's just really dense. I have no idea where my ship went. Oh, there it is. There we go. Ship is. You might have to reposition your camera. Hold left alt to move the camera. Okay. That's good to know. Your ship needs a crew. You can hire crewmen at nearly every station. Oh, okay. Fly to the highlighted dock at the nearby station. If your ship is slow, it's because you don't have engineers yet and can't fly at full speed. That's why we're hiring a crew. Okay. And here I was about to Google this and try to figure out why the hell everything's moving so damn slow. This is a horribly ugly ship. Baby down. Dang, this is slow. I'm almost there. Press F to dock. What can we do for you? Hire crew. So I need mechanics. I can choose how many I'm gonna hire. What was that? One. What can I hold? Higher. Crewmen for arming all the turrets. For armed turrets. Not enough engineers. Okay. Hire 8 vanilla crewmen. Now close the window to continue. Open ship menu to assign your crew. Hit the crew button. Assign. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1. You need more sergeants. So unassign. Undassign. Close the window once you're ready. Ship is ready to explore the galaxy. Okay, what's this thing telling me here? Build more quarters to support your... Okay. So, I'll build iron crew quarters. And build lots of quarters. More thrusters. Because why not? Oh God. The ship is ready to explore the galaxy. Once you are ready to, click continue. And we will start flying to other sectors. Open the galaxy map. This is the galaxy map. Shows your location, faction, territories. You can find interesting things. Every square on the grid is a sector you can visit. Oh, wow. Sectors with green blinking dots are sectors from where you're receiving signals. And that might be worth checking out. Your blue radius around your location is a range of your hyperspace drive. You can jump to other sectors, but only within that range. The colors of the sector show the relationship between you and the faction controlling them. Green are good relations, blue is neutral, and red are bad relations. Once you've visited a sector with something interesting, it will be marked automatically on the map. Now right-click a sector that is in range and enter. Click enter coordinates in your navigation computer. This will start the calculation of your jump route. Once these calculations are done, you can jump to the sector. Okay. Do that one's within my jump range. Press escape to close the map. Wait until your nav computer does its thing. I don't see a timer anywhere. Where is this sector that I'm supposed to be going to? Right there. Press space to jump into the other sector. Oh, you just tap it. Nice. And I'm off. Press spacebar to continue. Hello there, are you off on adventure too? Absolutely. That's great. I'm sure we could help each other out if there's anything you'd ever like to know. Just ask away. The closer you get to the center of the galaxy, the better the materials you'll find. You'll be able to build energy generators or parts that protect your ship, like integrity blocks or even shield generators. First thing you should do is find yourself some titanium. Iron is great to get yourself started, but titanium is lighter and you can build better parts with it. And be wary of the no man's space around here. I hear there's a pirate leader who terrorizes everyone who strays too far from the civilized sectors. Alright, see ya, dude. I am not moving far at all. And I've got plenty of iron. I wonder if I could throw some more thrusters on this baby. Let's do this here. Iron cargo bay. Iron cargo bay. And then engine here and here. Yeah. here, and here, and here, and here. And here, and here. And here, and here. Hehehe. Not enough engineers. Okay, I'll remove these ones again then. Click, delete, click, delete. Now we're flying. And I will move this up slightly. I think that looks a little better. Congratulations, you successfully jumped to another sector. This is your hyperspace drive energy. After a jump is depleted, you have to wait until it recharges before you can jump again. Okay. Oh. Okay, went way too far. If you're rather full, your ship consumes nearly all the energy it can produce, or even more, which is more likely to be a bad thing. Excess energy gets stored in your battery and drained during energy shortages. Once you have no more energy left in your battery, your ship systems start to fail. Return to the previous sector. Okay, so ooh. That's interesting. Hitting Z and X does this. Looks like Q pushes you down. E boosts you up. Those overheat way too fast. Okay, back to the nav computer. Head back here. Enter coordinates. Congratulations, you finished the tutorial. For more advanced tutorials, see the drop-down menu in the tutorial window. You can always restart the tutorial with this button. You can sell or buy resources for money at a resource depot. Sweet. Oops. Wrong button. Okay, what is that telling me? Your hyperspace engine. Ship is using more energy than it can produce. Okay. Well, how do I produce more energy? That I'm not sure. Solar panel, eh? Solar panels all around this baby. And I need more mechanics now. Beautiful. A gorgeous ship. Producing all the energy now. Let's go harvest some more iron.
Yo!
I'm running out of energy. Ship is damaged. Your face is damaged. What's damaged? My thing? It's working. Not sure why that wasn't working before. Yeah, overall, I really like this game. I could see I could spend hours designing a ship. So I might play this game some more, make another video of my favorite ship, but, yeah. Let me know in the comment section what you guys think, or what you want me to try to make a ship to look like, and I might come back to it and attempt to make a ship that's looks cool, but at the same time is practical. But, yeah. As always, thanks for watching. Tesla Gojira out!